Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, and today you guys is Makeup Monday. So let's begin, or you can say get ready with me, whatever you want to call it. But yeah, let's go ahead and get all fixed up for today. Same old stuff. Like I said, I have some new products though. But what I was about to say, same skincare prep stuff is what I do. And so, but I do have a couple of new products that I will be using, such as this brand called Oliver. It's the color changing foundation. It's a 2-in-1 design foundation and brush. I got this online, so this is a fairly new product right here. I'm excited to try that. Another product I will be using is this Milani cream to powder foundation. It's my contour shade. This is in tan. I think it's in tan. Something's loose in here. I don't know what's loose in there. Was it loose the other day? Oh, I know what it is. Okay, it's just a powder puff, but it's in tan. I'm gonna use this as a contour shade, but eventually I'm gonna use it all over my face. And I think that's about it, you guys. Everything else I think is pretty much the same. I do have, yes, I do have the L'Oreal Infallible Stick Sculpt Blush. I think this is in Cheeky Dimension. I haven't tried this one, so it's a pink blush. I have on a lot of pink and peach on, so I will use that. And also, you guys, I probably use this Wet n Wild Incognito Mega Last Concealer, which is my current favorite concealer. Now, it's possible if that Milani cream to powder foundation doesn't work, I might use the ILF 16 hour camo concealer in the shade Rich Ebony. They had cocoa, but the ones that was in cocoa, everybody had opened up for some reason. I don't understand why people do that. They had opened up every single pack, so I kind of got upset, but I was like, okay, I can make this work as well. Okay, so I think that's about it for its new products. Now, this Wet n Wild is not a new product. I don't even know why I even said that, but I guess because I saw it in here. Everything else I think I've showed y'all for the, you know, like the past few videos. So, yeah, those are the four new products that I will be using today in my videos. So, first of all, you guys, I hope the lighting is okay. I don't know. I got a new vanity table, like I was telling y'all. If y'all watch my, let's see, my car vlogs, you would know. I do have a new vanity table. I do have a lighted mirror that I'm very happy with. It's not too big. It's just right for this desk. And then I have two drawers down here. I am very pleased with it. And I just got something on my table, you guys. I have got to get this off. It looks like eyeliner. Let me get some makeup wipes. I think I got one more pack of makeup wipes here. I do. If I can reach them. Okay. Yes. I have one more pack of makeup wipes. It was just waiting for me. It knew something was going to get on my table. So, not really. But, yeah, I have these wipes here. I'm going to use this to just clean off this little like eyeliner. Probably came off of my hands. Okay, so yeah, I just got my new table and I don't want to like fuck it up, okay? Not this early. No, I don't, because y'all, I've been wanting a new table for a long time, like for real. I've been wanting one for a very long time and I've been blessed to get one, and so I'm gonna take care of it. It took a long time. I mean, it took me a long time to install this. But anyways, I got me one, so I'm happy about it. So yeah, y'all, let's go ahead and get into the video or it's gonna get too long. Okay, so first things first, the Marie Claire Super Hydration Face Moisturizer Hyaluronic Acid and Vitamin E Skin Renewal. I love this. I don't need to even say why. I've told y'all in many, many videos why I like this moisturizer. Oh my God, I got so much room, y'all. It feels good to have so much room. But this is like the best moisturizer ever. It doesn't like cause my foundation to get too oily. Unless it's just a very, I don't know. It hasn't really got too hot yet. So I'll find out whether I still feel the same when it gets really, really hot. Because it can get hot here. So we will find out about that. Like, we will find out, y'all. But so far, so good. This is the best moisturizer. I do feel like it's going to be summer appropriate. So I can still moisturize my skin. But yeah, it'd be real hot. Y'all know how it is when it gets in the summertime. You don't be wanting to moisturize because you feel like you're just going to sweat more. So, yeah. All right. I did do some exfoliation over the weekend and stuff. So, I hope my skin looks a little bit better. I did. I put on a mask. I exfoliated by shaving my face. And then I put on a mask. And then I used some of those under eye golden like pads that you put underneath the eyes. I used it. So I feel very secure about my skin today. However, I feel like I need to, I don't know. It's just so much. I don't like to wear makeup all the time. I really don't. Especially when I'm not going to tape a video. I'm trying to get back in the groove of like being like that person that will always put makeup on. But honestly, y'all, the older you get, the less, you know, you want to do those things, the less you got something to do. Like, I'm serious. If you ain't got nothing to do, then you're just like, I don't want no makeup on. So I'm just saying. And I feel like I'm way over here on the side. The reason being, the camera being so far on this side is because of the lighting. I still like natural lighting. And I have like this gap right here of lighting right here. So I feel very good that I do still like, I have lighting, natural lighting, even though I have to use these lights so that y'all can see everything really good. That's the purpose of it. Now, for primer, I tried the Revlon Prime, my favorite one here. This Revlon Prime Plus Mattifying Pore Reducing Primer is at the very bottom. I feel like I need to just put these in my empty or just throw this away. I need to repurchase. So I don't want to put that on. But y'all, I do think that this is what's causing me to break out. I didn't use it yesterday and I used another product and I see that the pimples are healing. However, I did put on a mask as well and it just kind of, you know how it just pulls all the impurities out of the skin. So, I don't know, you guys. Once again, this is the NYX Total Control, Drop Primer. I do think this might be breaking me out. I just need another primer. I don't have one. I did find the Milani one last night, and I probably have to pull that out. If I notice any breakouts today, I will just grab that one from Milani and use it as my primer, because I know that one does not break my skin out. But I think this one by NYX really does break my skin out. Just putting this primer on, y'all. So how was y'all weekend? I hope y'all had a good weekend. I had a good, blessed weekend. I mean, Everything's fine here in this area. A lot of bad weather all over the place. I hope everybody's doing okay. But thank God, you know, nothing around here like really basically happened. So, okay, so yeah, but I hope y'all had a good weekend. I still, like, I went out yesterday and I had to get a replacement of these two lamps. Y'all ain't gonna believe this. This has never happened before. One lamp went out here that I like to use when I tape videos. And then the other light I was using, and I rarely ever use this light over here, and it went out. I was like, what the hell? I was like, no, this has never happened. So I end up having to go out yesterday and pick up some, you know, like two more lamps. And you know what, y'all, I want to make this apparent so everybody know. Like, there is a light that I'm going to get for my webcam, because on my Shella Beauty Essence channel, sometimes I like to actually like tape on my webcam, and sometimes over here it's just faster, especially if I'm not going to do a long video. It's like a quick little video or whatnot. I know the lighting is not good, and then there's a light that I can get that goes right on top of the laptop. I'm thinking about getting that, but I'm telling you, y'all, if you're like a small YouTuber or something, or you're just a person on a budget, like, these little LED lights that you can basically get at Walmart is amazing. Like, y'all see the lighting in my video. Like, you see how lit I am here. And then, like, when I do my Taylor Tuesday videos or Fashion Friday videos, y'all see how I look back there. So these lighting, the lighting is very good. Like, they're just basically LED lamps, and they're very inexpensive, and y'all, that's good enough. That's good enough lighting. And then of course I have this small little ring light around my camera as well. So just saying, you don't have to go way out. And also, like, a lighted makeup mirror works too. However, I don't hardly ever use that except for when I'm getting ready, say at night or in the evening time. I rarely use my lighted mirror unless I have to, because I just like, you know, I do like to use it, but I like the look of it on my vanity more than anything. But anyways, you guys, let's get into this foundation, because I can keep talking and talking and talking. But I'm excited to try this. I've been holding on to this. I've been having it all week long. And I said, well, it was after Monday. I think I received this on Tuesday of last week, and I said, I'm not gonna try this. I'm gonna wait. It's a new type of foundation. It's new to me. It's called Aloe Vera, and once again, it's called the Color Changing Foundation 2-in-1 Design. It's a foundation and brush in one. It says it's a perfect, flawless, brightening moisture type of foundation that's smooth and satin-like texture, lightly covers skin imperfections, spots, acne marks, and traces, delicate pores, changing the natural makeup feeling that fits the skin tone perfectly, showing flawless beauty. Okay, so it covers a lot, and I feel like I'm gonna try it, because I've been using a BB cream that actually color match. Like, when you put it on, it goes on like clear, and then as you rub it in, it color changes. So see, this is brand new. Open it up right now. And I've been into these type of foundations because I feel like there's just, you know, there's no hard work in it. Like, what kind of hard work can you say that's in this? Because, like, it's basically gonna match you instantly. So I don't know. I think for the summertime, like, I really, really like this. And it came into this packaging, which is very unique. It hasn't been opened because I just opened it up. It had a seal. So it comes in like this wrapper-like thing here, which is very convenient. Like, it's different, okay? It's one of those products that you just find online. So you have like this foundation like covering here, and then there. Oh, this is so pretty. Like, y'all, look at this. This is so pretty. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? Like, that is so pretty. So you have like this side is the foundation. As you see, it just looks, it looks white, but when you put it on, it's gonna color match. And then on this side you have your brush. Isn't that so pretty? Like, y'all, this is first impression. Okay, get ready with me, or Makeup Monday, that's what I call it. So there's the brush, very unique like product. So let's try it out, you guys. And the brush, you have to be very careful about putting it back in the package, but I think this is very unique, so let's go ahead and try it. So I'm gonna roll it up some, about that much, like that, and I'm gonna swipe it on my skin a few times. And yes, right now it's gonna look like this, but it's gonna color match. So I'm gonna put it all over my face, and y'all know me, I'm gonna go, it's starting to color match now. And I did exfoliate and everything for this video, because I wanted everything to look its best, and that you get a good view at this, or a good view. Yes, I guess so, an accurate view. And it's starting to color match, which I like. I like stuff like this when it starts to get warm out, because you know how you get into, like, when it gets warmer, a lot of foundations that you use in the during the winter time, you will not use in the summer, because you're gonna, everything warms up and it's so pretty and everything's, everybody's bronzy and beautiful. So having something like this, like, you can see it changed colors on top. It looking a bit more like me on the top. So that's, you know, I just feel like foundations like this is very, very convenient in the summer. Now, I'm going to start to blend it in. I don't think I wait till it start to match. I think when I blend it in, it'll just start to activate, I think. I'm gonna use the brush. We will see, you guys. This is the first time of me using this product. I see it starting to warm up, but wow, it's taking a while. Maybe I put a tad bit too much, but usually this type of foundation will color change to your skin tone. It's supposed to. Right now, it's not looking completely like me. Okay, so we're going to give it a little time, just blend it on in. And from what I see, is I think it's supposed to be like a matte light finish, and you may not even need powder as well. So I don't know, it just depends on how oily you are, or you may be. Like, for me, I'm a little oily today, but not too oily. So I feel like I can go over my skin with the powder. And I like the brush. The brush is very soft. And I do like the size of the brush. It's very small, but enough. It's enough, okay? That you can use all of the face and just, yeah, make sure you put everything on. And then I'm gonna really see if this gonna color match, because right now I'm not seeing the color match, but just a little bit. And maybe you have to use a little at a time, maybe. But we're gonna like sit here, and even if I have to turn, like, cut the video and come back, because I know I don't want y'all to be just sitting here watching, waiting on this to really accurately color match. But it's supposed to be that way. And like I said, I love foundations like this in the summer. I used to use them all the time. Like back before I started doing YouTube, I used to use like color matching foundations and stuff. If I could find one, I would try it out. And sometimes they just didn't work because at the time they were irritating my skin. But like this is like, where is the color match? Like, where is it?
Usually, I have
this one and the another one that I used a time before. And this is the Garnier Miracle Skin Cream. Okay? This is amazing. Let me show you. As you can see on the top of the lid, I've used it. Like, you put this on your hand and watch it. It comes out white, but about time it touched the skin, like, and you rub it in, like, it's starting to change already. Like, watch this. See there? Look at that. It's instantly matched my hand, the skin on my hand. So this one here that I got right now, I don't know what's going on, but this is taking too much time. This should have already color matched unless I just put way too much product. But y'all, I put a good bit of that on because y'all know how I am with foundation. Like, I really put it on. If I'm gonna put on foundation, I put it on. I see it starting to like change colors a little bit, like change color, but it's not, it's taking too long. So I don't like that about this foundation. Like, what is the problem? Like, it's pretty packaging, I have to admit. The packaging is beautiful, but where is the color match? Like, this is not matching with my skin. Like, what the hell? This is a complete fail, okay? Not being mean, but this is completely failed. Because this should be just like the Garnier Miracle Cream. And I've worn that twice already, and I absolutely love it. So what am I gonna do about this? I feel like this will only be used as a base. You know how everybody used, like, I've been using like primer bases that's way too light for years, okay? So this I would not recommend. First impression, don't get like twisted with it saying that this will color match. No, it does not. This does not color match. This is something you would use as a base, a primer, for your foundation or something like that. Maybe to cover up acne marks or scars or whatever. Like, and to me, it doesn't cover as well as it states it does. But my face does look like a mask. So this is so deceiving. I'm very upset because I was thinking that this was gonna do what the Garnier Miracle Cream that I just showed y'all, how it matched my skin perfectly. Like, look at that, just a perfect match. Like, look at that. This, what's on my face is aloe vera. This does not do what it says. So this will be just a primer. I'm just saying, this is going to be just a primer, okay? That's all this is going to be. It's a freaking primer. There's no way I'm going to use this as foundation because it just do not match my skin. I'm putting it back in the packaging. I do like the packaging and all that, but I don't need to even put it back in the packaging. I'm just going to leave it out of the package, and yeah, I'll put it in my makeup drawer as a, like I said, like a primer. I use that as a primer, but not as a foundation. That just does not, y'all see how it looks. This does not match. So, and I'm not afraid to show y'all these things like this. Y'all know I've been doing it for years. So, now, I'll just grab my, say, I guess I could use the something that, let's see y'all, I'm just off guarded now because that did not work. I wasn't planning on having to use something different, okay? So I guess I'm gonna go in. I hope this doesn't interfere with the Garnier Miracle Skin Cream. Hopefully this doesn't interfere with that. I'm gonna put a little bit on my finger and see if this will not interfere. No, it doesn't. See, that's real. See that right there? Garnier Miracle Cream. Now that is accurate. Like, it's changing into like what it's supposed to do. So y'all, I'm gonna put this on, and I know I'm gonna need a good bit of it. And I wasn't prepared for this to happen, because I was thinking that this was really going to actually color change like this right here, the Garnier Miracle Cream. Okay, so this right here can get, only thing about the Garnier Miracle Cream is that it can get very, it can get thick really quick. So I would say use it a little at a time and then go back in, because I used it this week, and for me, or the weekend I should say, for me, you know, you have to be careful as to how much you put on and blah 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 and all of that. So, oh, another thing I'm gonna use is this charcoal brush. Yeah, you remember I had hauled this, it's the Therapeutics. No, I don't want to use that. No, I'm gonna wait till another video. Let's just use a regular foundation brush. I'm gonna use this Face Secrets or Beauty Secrets brush here, and I'm gonna blend this in. And as you can tell, that's starting to look more like my skin. It looks even better without that other Oliver stuff underneath. I probably have to go over it again with a second layer. So look at that, it's starting to look too, like, that looks too thick. You see what I'm saying? Like with the Garnier skin cream, you cannot add too much extra stuff. Like, I used that Oliver first, and then I went over with this right here, and it's just like, look at this. You can see the brush marks, you can see that that's too much product on my skin. It's too much. So only thing I can do from here is actually just remove some of it. Like, yeah, take my towel and remove some of it. That's way too much for my skin. Only thing left is to remove it. Okay, there we go. Now everything should be better now. So basically, I don't have to use the Garnier Miracle Cream, but I will, just because why not? I've already stored it, so let's go ahead and use this Miracle Cream by Garnier, and it doesn't take a whole lot of it either. So, and this is not going to give me full coverage, but with everything I put on, we're going to make it as much coverage. We're going to get the coverage. I'm going to get the coverage that I want. And I find that sometimes with this, like with creams like this, it's good just use your hands to rub it in like a lotion rather than a foundation that you normally use a brush. Like, just rubbing it in is way better. And you can see, like, you don't need much of this. I just feel like this product is kind of tricky though. I like it because it really does color match, but it's tricky because you can't use but so much, and you have to let go. So if some of y'all have a light hand, then okay, then you can use this with no issues. I'm a type of person, I like to put it on, okay? I like to put on makeup because I like it, okay? Simple as that. I put it on to cover a lot of things, and so yeah, I have to say that other stuff that I told y'all, like, it's really flaring up, like, it's really fucking up everything. That is so deceiving. They should be shaming themselves, that company. Like, that is not color changing. That's why I say some people, some companies, they be lying And I'm not saying everybody, but they need to stop with the lies, because we saw that. Everybody saw that. Y'all saw that on camera, that that did not change in color math. They be lying. Okay, so this looks better, but it's streaky. I'm not going to sit here, and I know y'all see this, but I'm going to fix it. I'm going to let it dry, because that's what I had to do over the weekend. I put a good bit on, and I had to sit there and let it dry. But this is more of a match than that Oliver, and I could put more. The problem is, because I have that Oliver stuff, Oliver, whatever it's called, on first, it kind of messed up this process a little bit. But let's fix it. Have y'all ever put on makeup and you just like, I'm not gonna redo this shit, I'm gonna make it work? I'm pretty sure everybody has done that. And then you just make it work, okay? So I'm gonna use this beauty sponge in here, and I'm gonna just dab this on and try to dry it up a little bit. This sponge is completely dry, no water on it. I haven't put water on it like I did the last time. I'm using it completely dry, and I'm gonna try to smooth this out with a dry sponge. Okay, so this is like what I do when I have a makeup mistake. When there's a mistake happens, whether it's the foundation didn't do what it's supposed to, or the primer fucked up on me, whatever. Excuse my language, but y'all know what I mean. Like, sometimes you put on stuff and it's like, what the hell? Or either my skin is just so rough and stuff is not smoothing out like it should, then I'm showing you what I would do. And I'm just drying it up right now. Drying it up. Okay. Put this sponge. The neck area is fine because I didn't put much of that Oliver stuff. Taking this off my lips. Okay, so now I have very minimum amount of foundation on, right? Very minimum. And I would prefer more foundation, because now I feel like I've taken off most of everything. I'm like right back from the beginning, which is nothing wrong with that. I'd rather start from the beginning, go back, start from the beginning, and then work myself back up to where I want to be. And this is without going to, like, this is helping me out. This sponge is helping me out from not going back to go wash my entire face and remove everything. However, sometimes you have to just take off something completely in order for everything to turn out right. So, with that being said, since I've done all of that, you guys, now I have the miracle cream that kind of smooth out everything, and with the added addition of the sponge, now I have this back side of the sponge that I can actually use a different foundation now. Yes. But this miracle cream beat the Oliver kind. Just saying, if you're looking for any kind of product, you know, to try to help out, you know, whatever, you know, just try to, you know, if you, what I mean is, this miracle cream will match your skin better than this Oliver. Only use that Oliver for a primer, okay? And very little of it on top of that. Very little. Don't use a whole lot. So what I'm going to do basically is I'm going to go ahead, instead of using like a whole lot of stuff, I'm going to take this Milani cream to powder foundation, because I can still see a little bit of that Oliver stuff on. And then, of course, the miracle cream kind of smoothed it up off my face. So I'm going to grab some of this Milani cream to powder foundation. And now I'm using the back side, and we're going to smooth this on top. Now that's starting to look better. So this may be a more of a natural look, you guys. We'll see. But this is a very nice contour shade. I was going to use it as a contour, but it didn't work out that way. So now I'm actually putting it on so that I could even out my skin. Okay. And it's working too. See there? It's working. Alright. So that's just a tip. Some of you probably may have already done that before, but I'm just saying, if that ever happens to you like that, where something didn't work out and it's claimed that it's supposed to do this, and it claimed it's supposed to be doing that, and then you put it on and it looked like the way mine, that Oliver looked, just grab you a sponge like that. These sponges come in handy, like for real. I know a lot of people love to use the beauty blender, and I do too, the beauty sponges. But I'm talking about like for errors and mistakes or things like that. These sponges are very, very nice to have. Like, this looks good too. And I like this color. Actually, this matches my skin tone. This is not even a contour shade. However, if I go real, real natural, it really is a contour shade. But this looks nice after putting on everything else. Like, this looks good. Okay, so just kind of rub it underneath my chin. I'm going to have to pull it down just a little bit on my neck, because it is just a little bit, but it's way better than the other, the Oliver. I do not like that. That gets a zero in my rating book. Like, that was so deceiving. Okay, that was very deceiving. Just a little bit more on the forehead. I'm just adding more color where I feel like I need more of this shade on my face to smooth out the errors from the previous foundation. Alright, I'm going to go with that. It's like a medium coverage. I could get full coverage with more product, but I don't really need too much product, because I've put on a good bit of products already. Alright, so from this point, I'm going to put on concealer. And I'm going to use my Wet n Wild Megalast Incognito Concealer. Yeah, I'm going to use it and put some on my eyes here. Right there, underneath. Right there. I did use a mask, one of those like iPads or whatever, underneath my eyes. It's like the golden mask. I like that 24 karat golden mask or something like that. I really like that mask, and I do see a difference with my under eyes today. Just saying, did some good skincare that I haven't done in a while. So I'm gonna wash my hands, because I don't want to get my drawers and stuff all dirty. All of that was just like, what the hell? Like, why was they so deceiving? Like, why in the hell was they so deceiving? That was so deceiving. Like, they just lied. That stuff did not do no color matching. That was so fucking deceiving. Okay, but anyways, let me grab a brush. I don't know why people would want to say something like that and it don't be what it claimed that it's supposed to do. Like, why would you do that? And this is going to look very brightening, but when I put on my eyeshadows and everything comes together, it's going to look fantastic. I don't like to do all the highlighting on my face. I just basically love to highlight around my eyes. That's just what I like. Everybody's different. I don't like to do all the highlighting. Sometimes I do, but very rarely do I do that. And a lot of times once you put this in on your skin, it just absorbs into the skin and you see the highlight, but it just absorbs into the skin, that concealer. And I absolutely love it. It's one of my favorites by Wet n Wild. I adore that. Too thick, it's brightening, it's just really nice concealer. I don't know what's going on with this camera. Like, it cuts off after so many minutes, and it just really makes me mad when it does that. But I'm blending out the concealer very well. I like it like that. Just blend it out good. And then if you want to, if you come down too far, you can take what's left on your foundation brush or sponge and just go around the corners of your face so it does that. So you can get even it out. Just even it out, okay? Alright, so that's what I'm doing right now. It's just evening it out. Okay, so now, you guys, it's time for the contour. Now, this I use as foundation with the Miracle Cream. I need to leave these out so I don't forget to remind y'all what I used. Okay, so now I'm going to take... Now, this may be a little extreme, but this is what I have. And I'm going to use it. So I'm going to take this, and it's almost time for also my powder. So I'm going to go ahead and take out my powders here, get prepared for that. Okay, so I normally like to go ahead and do my cream contour. I'm going to use the ILF 16 Hour Camo Concealer here in Rich Ebony. And they had cocoa, but somebody had, like, I don't know what's wrong with people. I don't know why people do stuff like this. Open up, like, you can open up stuff without, like, making a mess. And some people just go in and just make a terrible mess, and then you cannot purchase it because then it's just too much. It is just too much. Like, you cannot. And right now, who would do that? So, I'm blending this in to the best of my ability. You guys, I probably should put just one dot of that. But then, it's okay. I'm going to make it work. It's going to bring out my cheekbones. Stick it out. Once I put on the powder, and I can do some highlighting underneath my cheeks as well. So don't look at this and go, oh my god. Okay, listen, I already put two dots there. But you can fix everything, and this looks very beautiful and warm. I like how it's warming up my skin. I like that. And to me, I don't care how I put this on, it can be not so even. And I go back in with the translucent powder or whatever and just smooth it on out. It all works out, and you will see. All works out. Alright. So, with the contour shade being a little low, you can take your concealer brush, just even it out right here, or your foundation brush, just whatever you like, even that out. And then now for contour on top, I'm just going to use very little because I don't even need much of this, like one dot underneath the bottom. Like, this is so intense and so beautiful. I like that. So it only takes just a little bit. Like, see, that would have been perfect on my cheeks. One little dot. Like, this will last me a long time. And I like it. And I love how warm it looks. It looks so warm and so beautiful. So I'm just going to blend this in. And then on my cheeks, I actually like my cheeks looking flushed anyway. So I'm getting, like, this flush look already, and I haven't even put on like my blush color, so I like that. So I'm just gonna blend this all under my chin in here. Just like that. Drag it down a little bit. Even it out. Even it out all over. Okay. Now since the puff is a little bit drier, I can go back over my cheek area and smooth this out just a little bit more. And if you notice, I'm going up higher underneath my eyes and going far back to my temples. Okay? Alright. Amazing. Very good. Rich, intense, beautiful color there. Now, so, alright, where am I at? Now I'm at the point of putting on my translucent powder. I always use my Laura Mercier translucent powder because it's just what I like, and I don't know why it took me so long to even try this product. I'm very disappointed in myself. This is so good and so amazing. Highly recommended. And this is where you can kind of clean up the bronzer if you really wanted to. So I'm just setting my under eyes, but really I'm not going to correct the bronzer because it's going to work right on in with the blush color that I'm going to use, which is a cream blush. And just setting these under eyes. And I think I need just a little bit more powder. Just a little bit. Right up in here in the center. Brighten it up a little bit. Right up in there. So I started late today. Okay. Didn't get up to almost 2 o'clock. So, yeah. Alright. So now I'm going to go ahead and put on my entire setting powder. I'm going to use the, what is this? The CoverGirl Simply Ageless Instant Wrinkle Blurring Press Powder. I'm going to use this all over my face to set my face. My brushes! Like, what? Okay. Alright, so this is in natural beige. And I'm going to put this on. And I told y'all, as far as this is concerned, the blurring part, maybe it's the skin smoothing. I see that my skin do smooth out when I use this. Does it blur out like all kind of imperfections? No, it don't. But does it smooth my skin? Yes, it smooths the skin out a little bit. So maybe that's the blurring, that's what they're talking about. I do notice that my skin looks smoother, but as far as it blurring out, like these acne little marks and stuff I got on my chin, like it didn't do anything. But my skin do look smoother. Okay, and so you guys, so that was the CoverGirl Simply Ageless Instant Wrinkle Blurring Press.
Got my brows done, so now we can finish
the eyes.
Vitamin C,
using the Makeup Revolution palette.
I do like this, but I feel like putting on this pink
shade, kind of just like that I started out with. And I'm just going to do this
eye
and
I
can finish the
other
one.
So, camera.
As far as bronzer goes, I'm going to use,
I put some lashes today.
Okay,
so
I always do that.
But you know what?
I be wanting to
they
use
just
something else.
Sometimes I really do.
Love that.
Take up so much time.
So now I'm going to go in with this other pink shade that's in this palette called
Force.
And you know what I think I may do over the powder? I think I'm gonna go back over with
kind of right up on that shimmer shade
foundation,
the Milani,
but I'm just
deepening up
cream to powder shade here, just
product,
and just kind of press it in, and maybe I can press it in
and
afforded. With this foundation brush, hopefully it doesn't interfere with anything. And just kind of press it on. And that will be my bronzer. Because it's on top of a powder. Now I'm going to take the lighter pink.
Is cream shade
Bond. So maybe somewhat of a natural bronze is what I'm trying to tell y'all. It has a little sparkle in it.
Camo concealer in rich ebony.
I'm going to just add that on to my skin. And try to get, you know, that little bronze, like light.
Go ahead.
Clean natural bronze look.
And on the side.
Let it go like that.
Kind of keeps me in line
there. I
think
I like that a lot. Like that.
Now,
I'm going to take this shade here.
And then on the side of my nose.
Red, brown shade here. It's actually the blush in
shade.
I take it and I'm going to deepen up on the side here. The corner here of my eye, and actually I have the
remember
right
it's gonna be a cream.
That's for the
cream
to powder
type of look
thing about, but
or foundation.
And this is going to be
outer V area of my eye here,
it's right here. I'm not used to it, but it's going on top of the powder. And some people say that this works, so I thought, why not give it a try? Let's try it out. So this look is like a Makeup Monday, but it's like trying different techniques and what do I do when I made mistakes, or how do I correct it without having to go wash my entire face.
It kind
of that sort of
look
thing, and I'm not liking the contour.
I thought it would look a little pink.
Really contouring
it?
My nose, like my I don't feel like my nose is contoured. I don't know if this is gonna work
gonna
for my
go with it,
my nose contour. Yeah, y'all know how I am.
It.
So
I'm gonna
add just a little bit of this.
I'm gonna
rich,
go ahead and put that shade underneath.
Ebony, just my lash line, the same shade from
and then just
this medium deep
palette
here. The Milani All Inclusive.
I like what I like.
I'm gonna put this underneath my lash line. My contour lines and all. Alright. Now I'm going to clean this up just a little bit. And that is grab this brush. Go over it.
Just like that.
Maybe
okay.
Add just a little bit.
And
then on my lid.
What the hell? This is real easy to drop.
I don't know what
this,
I want to use on my lid.
Sponge. I ain't dropped it yet.
I haven't really thought about what I want to put on my lid.
Okay, so adding on more product here.
I do have some really good pigments in this Ultimate Utopia.
Now I'm seeing the contour.
Now I'm going to add on more of the translucent Laura Mercier translucent powder.
This is like a peach shade.
Oh yeah, that's perfect.
And
I might go back in with another shade, but I'm going to use this peach shade from this palette and just add it on
right here
to my lid here.
Okay, that's
so
a good
pretty
amount of contour. I'm going to leave it somewhat natural. I'm not going to go overboard with
it's
it.
Really cute.
Just a little naturalness going on here.
There we go. Now, basically, you guys,
I like the combination of
blush color I could also use.
It's, so, I'm going to go ahead
and
I'm
going
to
do something else.
It's the L'Oreal Infallible
liner here.
Cheeky Dimension.
And I forgot what
shade I use. I think I used
and
the
I'm going to add
shade
just a little
I
bit.
I really
like
cheeks
this color, so. Oh, shoot. I'm sorry, y'all. My stand just don't work properly for some reason.
Like this.
Alright, so I'm gonna take this blush shade
on
Peach and
Pink.
I'm gonna really like get this into the corner
and
here.
Then I'm gonna use my brush
and blend it out
of me portion of
I don't want it too bold. Yesterday I had it on really bold like and I don't want it real bold.
I want it to be soft and sweet.
All right. Like me. Now soft, I'm going to take
my beauty sponge.
I'm going to add just a little bit more right up in there.
Clean this up
on the apples of my cheeks. Good.
Nicely. Yes.
And now, what I was thinking about doing is actually lining my eye, my inner eye, with my liner. Right. Where's my liner at? This is the L'Oreal Infallible Longwear Eye Pencil.
This
here
is so natural that I'm not used my to inner natural corner here.
Okay, I'm really not. So that's sort of natural, but it can get intense. I could get it intense, but right now I think it looks good. I'm going to take an eyeshadow palette, my two favorite palettes. I think I'm going to intensify my eye look. So I think I'm going to take this Milani All-Inclusive Eye Cheek Face Palette. This one is the medium to deep color here. And then I'm going to take also the Makeup
and
Revolution
then on top,
palette here
in eyeshadow
forever. And I am
and
going to
one of these eyeshadows from the Ultimate Utopia,
the black shade,
because that's where we I'm going to take right
it
now is the eye.
And I want it to look so a little smudge, back
so I have to clean the rest of them up. So
just go right
trying
on my
to keep
line,
my brushes
right
off my
line,
table.
Waterline.
Yeah. Yes, I'm a lash out. And
I want to smear it.
So
I don't want it. I want it
this
smudge,
is how it looks.
Smeared,
everybody know what it looks
smudge
like.
So I ain't got to show y'all anything because you know. So the first thing I'm going to start with is
I think
neat.
Is this the really
right? That is it. So I'm going to take the shade called Bond. I know y'all do not see this, but it's in the Makeup Revolution palette. It's called Bond. And I'm going to put this. I know I haven't done my brows yet, you guys. I was supposed to have done my brows first. It always helps out if you do your brows first before putting on eyeshadows. So I really need to do that.
Like that.
I just happen to think about my brows. It's not complete. And I might even put a line on my. I might just.
And
bring
I
it
love
out
to just create
look at you guys. I'm trying to hurry.
Monday, which is the day that you really just kind of have to
my battery
yourself together and everything.
I'm just like,
after
you
resting the entire weekend, it's like, what?
I would like to like brighten up the shade underneath my eye just a little bit. So I'm going to take the same brush, I'm going to wipe off the black shade, and I'm going to use this really light vivid pink shade here from the Bold Pro Bold Clean Color Palette. I'm going to take it and just add, let me put this on, you guys, and then what I'm going to do real quick is my brows. Let me do my brows off camera. It's going to be the same product that I showed y'all.
Taking some of the glitter shade.
In my last video is this Click and Click and Flick.
Now I'm going to take the highlight shade from
the Candy, the Groom Tame and Milani palette. I also use the L'Oreal Infallible liner here to help just kind
of
line everything
sort of,
and so this takes a little while, so I'm gonna cut it off and then come back to the eyes. Okay, I'll be back in a minute. Okay, like that. Okay, you guys, so and then like I said, I'm gonna wing it a little bit, and in order to wing it, a lot of times I like to use this Rimmel Ink Me eye and body liner. So I like to pull it out and yeah, just sort of want a bold wing, but like that. My hooded eyes, but that's okay though. And then I do like the smudge smudge look here that's going on, but I do feel like it's a little uneven without the liner being on there completely. I feel like that smudge look looks nice, but I'm gonna add a line right on my lash line as neat as I can. Just like that. Then taking the brush here, I'm going to take the black shade and smudge it out again, okay? Just a little bit because I lost the smudginess. There we go. Now, okay, so now I'm just lacking the lashes, and then everything will come together. I feel like, though, I should use just a little bit more of a peachy color if I have one in this Clean Color Pro Bold palette. Let me go ahead and try to add something a little different. I think I'm gonna add this like orange shade and maybe a little this light pink shade and see what this may look like on top here onto my brow bone. Yes, I pull it up that high at times. I'm gonna add a little bit more of that orange shade just to give a ray of color here, different like pick me up colors. Not really. But I just like, you know, the ray of colors. Okay. Put it on up. Okay, just like that. Then go in with and highlight. And then this look is complete except for my mascara, my liner. Well, I got my liner, but my mascara and my wing. Well, I got my wing too, but my lashes. Y'all, it's Monday. Y'all wouldn't believe like what's going on outside my window. It's so crazy. People be crazy. But I'm not too scared to confront you, baby. I walk to you and ask you what your problem is. What seems to be the problem? Holding my shoulder. Okay, my belt. Okay, anyways, guys. Let me go ahead. So yeah, this is basically it. I'm gonna use my mascara, the Lash Sensational Curvitude mascara. I'm go ahead and put some on my bottom lashes. I'm not a huge fan of this mascara, but it's not really that bad. I do like how it separates my lashes though, especially on the bottom lashes, like. Yes, so cute. There we go. Bomb lashes. So, for the top, I feel like I want to put on a pair of lashes just because I think it will look cute all together. But we will see, you guys. So, let me go ahead and finish this eye. I'll come back and I think I might put a little bit more blush on. All right, you guys. Be back in a look. All right, you guys. So, this is the look, you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope that the view was good. I didn't know if I should have kept the light on this side. I'm going to turn on the light over here. I don't know if that makes any difference. I'm trying to figure out because now I'm not over in the center. I'm over here on this side, which is wonderful. I like it, but I just don't know about the lighting. Maybe this is better, maybe it's not. I'll find out when I look at it. But y'all, this is the finished look. Okay, so basically what I did a little something different. Okay, I did keep the shadows on from the Milani all-inclusive palette. This one here, the medium deep. I did use the Makeup Revelations. Oh my God, Makeup Revolution palette right here, and I did use the Clean Color Pro Bold palette, you know, and I used the NYX Ultimate Utopia palette as well. But what I decided to do also, I don't know, I wasn't content with the like shimmer shade from the NYX Utopia palette, so I wanted a little more glitter, and then I decided to go with a more like a purplish color because of my top and all being pink. See here, so I wanted something, even though this is kind of pink with the Milani palette, but I still wanted something a little bit more pink, so I decided to use this palette right here. So we have the purple tone here, and I used that. That's a purple tone that you see here. And then I also used these two glitters right here in the inner corner. So I used those just to add a little sparkle, a little something, because I decided to put on the lashes. So that's what I did a little different. Everything else is the same. Y'all saw I used the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Last eyeliner on the bottom, and then I smushed out the black eyeshadow from the NYX Utopia palette. And then let's get into these new products, okay? All right. This right here, I'm very upset about. It's so pretty and sleek. I like it. Y'all, I'm just very disappointed in it because this does not color change. I don't know how long it might take for it to do its due. But right now, like, this is about as deep as this stick goes. I'm gonna keep that on my hands a little while, and maybe, just maybe, you guys, it might just take a little bit longer time to color change into the skin or whatnot, because right now, as y'all see, it looks a little deeper in tone than it did on my face. I'm hoping that this does work, because this is creamy, you guys. When you apply it to the skin, it feels very creamy and easy to blend out with the brush. I think this is a unique product. This is something that, you know, some people have had like many products like this. You have the foundation, you have the brush, but this is in one piece, like one product, and I like that. The thing is, I feel like this is just not deep enough. It's not color changing the way it should. So I'm a little disappointed, but I'm gonna keep this on my hand just to see, does this product take a longer time to match your skin tone? Maybe it takes a little time for it to match my skin tone. Maybe that's the issue. I don't know, but I really like the product. I hope that do be the issue or the problem, and then I will know next time just to put it on for a little while, wait to tape, and then you know, have my foundation on or whatnot. So that might be the issue with that, but we will find out. But hold on for a minute, you guys. Just a second. I hate to interrupt, but this is something that I've got to do. I'm back. So, now, okay. So, I hope that be the issue, but as you can see, it still looks lighter, way lighter than my skin. And so, I don't know if it's going to work or not. I'm just very disappointed in that product, you guys. But I can use it as a primer. I wouldn't mix it with a BB cream. I don't know about a CC cream. I wouldn't try that. I would probably use it only with foundation. You know, use it as a primer base for the face. Okay, because I can still use this product for a primer base, and hopefully that will work out. Okay, so just as foundation, it doesn't work if, I'm going to say this, it doesn't work if you're medium skin or a deeper. It just doesn't work. Y'all saw that. This is about as deep as this shade's going to get, so far, unless I give y'all update and say, you know what, in 30 minutes time, it finally, hopefully not, because most of us, you know, we like to put on our foundation and it match instantly, or by the time you put a foundation that's supposed to color match, you expect it to just kind of automatically, like once you blend it in, it just kind of match. I hope it's not one of those foundations that it literally takes like a while to change, and it could be. Alright, but I absolutely love the Garnier Miracle Skin Cream Anti-Aging Skin Transforming Care. This is a very wonderful product for every day. I absolutely love it, you guys. It's amazing. This product does so much. I don't have the particular the product that this product came out of, like the actual ingredients. It has it on the back, but I do not know how to, like, this is in another language. I don't know what it says, but anyways, this one really does transform into your skin tone. I really, really like it. I used it over the weekend and it looks very natural. And also you can add, of course, makeup on top of it. It looked really nice over the weekend. This is like an everyday type of makeup product or makeup cream, foundation. It's very nice. Once again, it's the Garnier Miracle Skin Cream. I would not use this as a primer because, as you can see, it can get a little patchy, and it got a little patchy with me over the weekend without having, only thing I used was my moisturizer and my primer, and it was still a little patchy. So I think this is one of the products that you probably just need to use alone, or maybe with a little moisturizer, no primer, because this has a lot to it. It has SPF in it, a lot of good stuff. So I don't even think you need a primer, because it's supposed to be like for natural days, I think. But this is really, really good. I really like that. So that's one of the products that I really, really love and would highly recommend, that product. Now, the Milani Cream to Powder Foundation, this is in tan. I did use this as my foundation. That's what I have on right now. I do like it. It ended up looking really nice. Actually, this worked better as a foundation rather than just a contour. But let me tell you, when I use the Garnier Miracle Skin Cream here, this works really good as a contour shade. So it just depends on what product I use. But if I'm going to go in with the, like a bold or if I've used several products and make a mistake, I know that this can correct it. Another thing is, I would not actually use this like on top of a really good foundation. I feel like it would be too much product, because this is your foundation. This is actual a cream powder foundation. Okay, so it's by Milani. I like this, so I use this to correct the issues that I had with the Oliver foundation. So yeah, and then this right here, the L'Oreal Infallible Stick blush. This is in Cheeky Dimension. I love this. I did go back over and added a little extra. It's still quite sheer, but I like it because my eyes is very, like the eyeshadows are very intense. So if you're looking for a nice sheer like color, like when you put it on, it's somewhat bold like that. It looks like a coral color, but when you blend it, it blends out sheer. So just saying, but I like that. It's going to be beautiful for the summer months and all, and even for those days when you want to use like a miracle cream, skin cream, like that Garnier Miracle Skin Cream product or a BB cream or something like that, this will look really, really nice. So I really like that product. All right, so yeah, I think that's about it, you guys. So once again, I'm going to take a look at my hand now, y'all. It hasn't changed much at all. Like, I just feel like this product is not doing what it's supposed to do. So this is like supposed to have been like the main reason for me like even making this video a new product, okay? But this is just gonna be a primer for me. Once again, this is called aloe vera, and it's supposed to like, and it did, it covered a little bit. It's supposed to cover a lot of scars, a lot of imperfections. However, I really wasn't able to really use this product completely as full as maybe I needed to cover a lot of things. This is just not working for my medium skin tone. That is just pitiful. That's just really terrible. I do like the packaging. I like the fact, I like the fact you got a brush on this side. Once again, you guys, I'm very disappointed with this product. I do not like this, and I'm telling all of you right now, I do not like it. And so, yeah, that's all I can say. So, this is the video, you guys. I'm sorry for the many parts you might have seen. It's just so much have been going on today while I've been taping this video. Like, no shit. Like, so much. But I got it done, and hopefully you guys like it. I don't know if I'm going to be doing my Taylor Tuesday video next. I might be doing it next. Then again, I might wait till tomorrow. I don't know what I'm going to do, but yeah, I hope y'all enjoyed this makeup video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to comment, and also share this video if you like. And yeah, you guys, I mean, look at this. This is the makeup look. I know I'm like really close, but yeah, I can't help it. So this is the look. All right, I look, the lashes, the foundation. I made it work. So y'all remember, if you ever need, like, you put on a foundation or a cream and it just doesn't match, or it just looks terrible, these sponges like this comes in handy. You can also use these to apply your foundation. I did in my previous video with you guys. These sponges right here, the sponges that I'm speaking of right now, is absolutely amazing. They do apply foundation, concealer, powder, everything. You can contour with these sponges, you can add a foundation, like I said, concealer, anything. Also, these are good to correct your makeup. They're absolutely fabulous. I want to put this in the video because I think a lot of people look at these sponges and go, those are so old school. These used to be in the compact type of foundations, but y'all, these are really good to correct mistakes. Or if you put too much foundation on, you can grab a dry one, just a dry one, don't wet it, and just absorb it like I did. I kind of smooth out all of that product from that aloe vera, and plus that then the miracle cream, skin cream, was able to just come on through, and it didn't look like I had like a lot of patches of makeup, and y'all know how bad it looked from the beginning. So these are really good, you guys, and these are very inexpensive. Like, you get, I think, 3 in a pack at some places for just $1.70 or $1.80, something like that. It might even be $1.60. But anyways, it's $1 and something for 3. And then you can buy bigger packs. And that's what I'm going to do because I'm down to one more. And yeah, this is really, really good for to correct mistakes as well as apply foundations, concealers, and stuff like that. So Yes, you guys. So that is it. That's the product. I hope you all enjoyed this video. I did. I always enjoy creating videos for you guys. I love coming in here doing this, but I am very excited to actually do the Taylor Tuesday video and my Fashion Friday videos. Those are my funnest videos. I'm absolutely in love with fashion videos, and I love doing these makeup videos. Like, makeup is a part of what I do enjoy. It's one of those things that I do like to do, but I love the fashion thing now. I'm so into it. Gotta learn more about it. I'm trying to get into like patterns and materials and stuff like that. What do you call this? What do you call that? But y'all, I love my fashion videos, and I just might go ahead and do Taylor Tuesday right today. I might just go ahead and do it. Then again, I might wait till tomorrow. So I don't know. Y'all find out. If I have on the same makeup, y'all see me with the same makeup look, then y'all will know she went ahead and created her fashion or Taylor Tuesday video. So yeah, you guys, I am excited. I have a few pieces that I really want to show y'all. But anyways, you guys, thank you for watching. Once again, don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and share this video. And I will see y'all in my next video. Sorry if this video was very, very long. So much was going on when I would cut off the camera, or the camera would cut off. You wouldn't believe all the stuff that went on today while I was taping. But hey, I got this video done. Thank you for watching, and y'all be careful out there, and I will see y'all in my next video. Much love. Bye-bye.